Hello and welcome to the second session on IoT applications. In this session, we will see how to extract the data from any website, real-time data, which act as a server, and then our WSN board, that is which has a ESP8266, will act as a client and will display the data on PC terminal. Since the board right now doesn't have any display or LCD, there is no microcontroller here. So whatever is the data this client receives, we will display it. Since we have connected USB to PC, so we will display the data on the PC terminal. So ESP8266 acts as a client. So for this purpose, we will be using two websites. One website is where we want to extract the data. That is, for example, one of the website is timeanddate.com. So if you, for this practical, we need to have the internet access on to your PC as well as your mobile, which act as an access point. So mobile is just accessing, we are using just as an access point, so that ESP8266 is connected to your mobile phone for getting the internet access, so that the data is displayed through ESP8266. Okay, so if you refer any websites, one of the websites is timeanddate.com. So this has a provision for various applications, but one simple application which we are using is world clock. So if you go to main world clock, so we are interested in displaying, for example, Mumbai, say current date, time, month, years, and so on. So this updated information we want to, so here now this act as a server for us. So this server data, real-time data, date and time, we want to extract it from this website and we'll display it on our client side. So for that, what is the procedure? Since we are not interested in this, all the features of this website, we are interested only this portion. So what we do is the URL of this feature, we will copy it, and we use some other website which act as for us as a API, application program interface. So through that, where our client will request to the API, and the API in turn will get the data from this server. Okay, so now let us select the feature which we are interested. So we are interested in this time. Right click. Then there is a option called inspect. Select the inspect. Then you will see the HTML code which is displayed on your right side. So there you will see one highlighted in blue color portion, that is the path which we are interested in copying. So again right click, you will notice there is a copy command, copy XPath. So you have copied. So we have created the path for extracting the time and date from this website. So that's all as far as this website is concerned. Copy the path, XPath. The second step is create a project on thingspeak.com so that it acts as a API for us to extract the selected portion of data from timeanddate.com. So you can go to thingspeak.com. The first step is create your own account. You give your email ID, username and password. So it will create an account for you. and confirm the account through your email. So once it is confirmed, then you will see a new channel is created, whichever is the channel name you had given. So since this is a free website, so anybody can use the official email ID and can register on this website, which act as a some service provider, where you can implement, as you can say, a number of examples, various microcontrollers and their interfaces can be connected for displaying the data or extracting the data in real time. Fine, so we want to use the apps. So go to apps. There are a lot of analytics are possible. Right now we are interested in things HTTP for communication purpose. So you can create a new thing HTTP, or I have already created one, so I will just edit. Now these are the fields. The minimum fields you should fill is, it have already given some request name, otherwise you can give some meaningful name. Second thing is URL. So URL is nothing but your times.data.com. So this URL, you should copy it and you paste it here in this space. That is the first step. Second is parse string. So parse string is nothing but the one which you have copied here. That is right click, copy, and copy XPath. That you paste it in this parse string. So once you paste it this, then you say save thing HTTP. So once you save things HTTP, you will notice it will create one URL for you. So this is the URL which we will be using on our client side. So what you do is you copy this URL and paste it in some notepad, so that you need to slightly modify the URL provided by thingspeak.com. So that we will discuss, but first paste it to any editor. Okay. Similarly, if you want to confirm whatever is the URL it has created, will it really extract the data or not, right click and go to HTTP. So if you select it on a new browser, it will display the real time which is extracted from the timeanddate.com. So just to repeat, whichever is the portion you are interested in, you select that portion, right click, say inspect, then you will notice something is highlighted which says in single line, it says some CT, hours, minutes, seconds, and so on. So this, you copy the XPath, then go to your thingspeak.com. There the channel which you have created, give some meaningful name and give the URL of the website from where you want to extract the data, and the parse string from XPath, whatever you have copied, that you paste it here. As you can see, some CT, whatever it displays there, and then you save it, save things HTTP. So it will create a API key and will give a URL for you. So just to confirm whether this URL is correct or not, select it, right click, and go to the browser. So it will should display whatever is the portion you have selected. So this confirms that you are able to extract the data from the server. So for that, you have created a URL by using thingspeak.com. That's all. So this is the purpose of the two websites which we are using to create a URL. So after that, whatever we do it on the client side by using ESP8266, where we need to configure it to connect it to our access point, that is hotspot, and then we connect it to this website and through this URL we will extract the data. So this link URL, you paste it here. Now we need to rearrange this URL in this form. First say get space, and after that from this portion onwards you paste it here, then type http, then forward slash the version of http. If you see in http, you have selected http version as a 1, so give the same version of http. Then backward slash r, backward slash n, that is line feed and carriage return, and then you give the host address. So type host colon, then this host address, that is api thingspeak.com, that should come at the end, and then again backward slash r backward slash n 2 times, that is the line feed and carriage return. So this is exactly the path where we need to give it through our client ESP8266. So rearrange the URL which you have got from thingspeak.com to in this form first by using some notepad. All right. Okay, so the third part of this experiment is we need to configure ESP8266 in mode 3 so that it acts as a access point as well as the station. So like earlier we have done, make sure the device is connected, it has recognized as a COM3. So in ports, you need to select the baud rate of 115,200 and port 3 and say change. Then it is connected. Then you can go to the send command where repeats you select twice and carriage return line feed you select it. Now you first restart your device. So it should say okay. Okay, it is ready. So now we need to configure for mode 3. So okay, it is configured for mode 3. Then we need to verify what are the available Wi-Fi networks, that is CW LAP. So now it recognizes the access point, that is my hotspot is YS-RAW. So let me connect to this hotspot, that is AT plus CWJAP is equal to username and password of the access point. So AT plus CW YS semicolon begin YS-RAW semicolon end comma semicolon begin password semicolon end. So it should recognize the access point and it display that it is connected. Okay, so now we need to set up the TCP connection to the website, that is thingspeak.com. So for that, the command is CIP start AT plus. So AT plus CIP start. So the syntax is semicolon begin TCP semicolon end comma semicolon begin api.thingspeak.com semicolon end comma and the port address. Okay, so now it is connected, already connected. Fine. All right, so now the URL which we have got, that we need to send it through this command prompt. But for that, you need to give the number of characters, that is CIP send, how many characters are there in this URL. So for that, there is a website called lettercount.com. So you can go to the website called lettercount.com. There you paste the URL which you want to send it. So if you paste it here and calculate the count, it gives the number of characters are 101. But however, you need to subtract 6 from this, because backslash r, it count as a 2, but actually it is 1 character. So total number of character minus 6 is the count which we want to send it. So 95 is the count. So 80 plus CIP send is equal to 95. We have to type it. So 80 plus CIP send is 95. So after sending CIP send is equal to 95, send ASCII. By any chance, if it display error saying error, link is not valid, or DNS error, that means there is a possibility of net connection problem on your mobile phone. Either you restart and verify the net connection of your mobile phone, and it should establish a link to the thingspeak.com, then you can type the URL. So if there is no issue about your net connection, then the prompt will appear on your screen. So now the URL which we have got, we are supposed to paste it here. That is the modified version of this. Copy it and you should paste it here. Thing is okay. After typing the URL, send ASCII command, you will notice on screen the current time, you can see 6:43:19, exactly the same time what is displayed currently on your server, currentdate.com. So that is exactly displayed on your PC terminal, which is through your ESP8266, which is acting as a client and which has used the mobile Wi-Fi as a access point, and the time, current time, is displayed on the screen. So this is the example where real-time data from any website can be extracted by creating a API on thingspeak.com, and the URL we are passing through our ESP8266, where the mobile is acting as an access point.